all when you sit. Well, the spelling was correct though, we have pointed that out.
First heat of the women's 100 breaststroke. Six heats here. And the seeded ones to come later. Liesl Jones in her fourth Olympics. What a great Olympic record she has. Rebecca Soni as well. They were first and second respectively in Beijing.
Brie Larson has been the real surprise packet of 2012 from America, winning the trials.
And beating, obviously, Soni in the process. Yeah, that was a shock.
And went from a 110 personal best time to a 105 to win that trial.
So the trick, I guess, is if you can back that up.
Yes, especially when you're new to competition.
That was a stunning breakthrough, wasn't it? So the first of six heats. So we've got Mongolia, Guam, Bosnia Herzegovina, Fiji, Azerbaijan and Guinea here. So a little bit of everything, don't we? But it's great. It just shows you where swimming's reaching out to.
It does show that the depth of the countries participating. All of the countries that are a little bit slower than the big nations, they had a qualification that was slightly different. We had an A qualifying, which was quite fast, top eight in the world. We had a B qualifying. And then these athletes were given a special dispensation by FINA, the International Swimming Federation, to be able to enter. So, but they had to have gone to the World Championships in 2011 to be able to qualify for that. And in fact, Equatorial Guinea, that had planned to be here, were disallowed with 3 days to go because they had not fulfilled that commitment of going to the World Championships, despite the fact that they've only had a 50-metre pool open in the last 6 months and they've only just started training.
Well, that's,
it's a shame.
It is a shame. So there's the lineup, as you can see. Mongolia, Guam, Bosnia Herzegovina, Fiji, Azerbaijan, and Guinea, the countries that are represented. Now the swimmers. Gantamir of Mongolia, Shimizu, Guam, Ninkovic of Bosnia Herzegovina, Budromo, Fiji, Atom Kanova of Azerbaijan, and Kamara of Guinea. Now the fastest swimmer on times is Ninkovic of Bosnia Herzegovina at 71.19.
Yeah, and she's doing a nice job right now leading it out in the centre of the pool there wearing the black cap. She went to the World Championships in 2011, went 1:14, although she has an entry time here of 1:11. Let's see where she is at the 50 to see how she's progressing. That's going to be a fast time for her.
16 years of age, so we've got three 16-year-olds here in lanes 3, 4 and 5.
33 seconds at the 50-metre mark, so if she can maintain this kind of pacing, she will be around that 1:11. Let's see if she can do a personal best time. Shimizu is trying to make a little bit of a move here as well. She has an entry time of 1:16, so she's on course to do much faster.
So Nikovic will probably hang on, and she will. She's got about a body length up. Budromo from Fiji's in third place. She's had a good back half as well, so that clock's going to get to about 1:13, 1:14, I think. So it's 1:14.04 for Ninkovic. So she's just outside her best time. 1:15.76 for Shimizu. So she gets that time that you were looking at.
Yeah.
And Budromo is not far outside her best as well. And the last of them coming in. And a big cheer coming up. Here we come for lane 7. Kamara of Guinea. Her best time is 1:40. So she's going to be, let's see, close to that. It is. It's the best time she's ever done.
What a great effort.
But just 16, this young lady.
Yeah, she did a great job. 33 seconds at the 50-metre mark, 41 seconds on the way home. So just a little bit more time in the sport, a bit more work, and she'll be able to hold that second 50 much faster. Quite high in the water. A lot of clearance with the mouth and the face to get the breath in. You'll see different, very different strokes and techniques in breaststroke. The hands come up and under and then shoot forward and then palms down. Nice touch on the wall too.
Technical event, isn't it?
It is. We often joke that it is its own sport. It's a hard one for kids to learn too, the breaststroke, the froggy kick. You're either a natural or you have to work very hard.
There's the result of our first of six heats in the women's 100 breaststroke. So Ivana Ninkovic, the 16-year-old from Bosnia Herzegovina, taking it out. Eight to go in the second heat. Taja Vazil of Slovenia, 69.22. So again, what sort of world class, what sort of mark? Is it
68? 105. That's how fast we're going to go to win it.
Oh, okay.
105. Through to semi-finals, 108.
Okay, so about 68. Yeah.
Take your mark.
So from the top, it's Berbrun from St. Lucia, Rodriguez of Portugal, Lukanen of Finland, Vazil of Slovenia, Stankovic of Hungary, Babu of France, Shen of Taipei, and Shishka of Moldova.
Stankovic at the moment is making a nice move from Hungary in lane number 5, finalist of the 4x100 medley relay at the European Championships earlier this year. Quite a good technique underneath. Does she get there at the 50?
Stankovic just by 1/100th of a second here. So the times here, we've got 5 of the swimmers have got a time in the very high 69s, just under the 110 barrier. So they're the swimmers in lanes 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6.
Babu is really coming through from France in lane number 6, has an entry time of 109. Let's hope they can get under that 110 barrier. They're coming in now with just 10 metres to go.
So maybe Vazil, Slovenia, though it's going to be close. Let's just say lane 6 having a real go, and so is lane 5. It is Vazil. So Vazil just gets there. Slovenia over Stankovic of Hungary, Babu of France. And that time, well, it's pretty good. 69.63. It's a good time, isn't it? And then 69.65 and 69.76. So they're all going to be, I think, pretty happy with that.
Differing techniques, a great shot showing that. But in the final stages, a very similar technique to Elisa Jones was Vazil getting on the wall. I like the fact at the pool here that there are lights on the blocks, so that if you touch first, one light comes up. If you touch second, two lights come up, and third, three lights. It's very clever.
Here's the result of heat 2. Vazil, Stankovic, and Babu, all in the 69s, just over 69 and a half seconds.
I haven't seen that at an international competition before, the lighting system.
Explain that to me again as we look at heat 3.
So if you touch first, you'll see there's a red light that comes up on that particular block as they touch. Second, two lights. Third, three lights.
It's good for the commentators,
too. It is good for the commentators. I should have told you on day one.
When you've been getting all the photos, right? No, I haven't. Thank you. Better late than never as we get to the third heat here at the 100 breaststroke. There's the lineup. So from the top, Gunardin of Turkey, Biljon of South Africa, El Bekri, who we saw yesterday, of Morocco, Gazzetti of Italy's got the fastest, 68.39, Jokova of Czech, and then Atkinson, Jamaica, Kim of Korea, and Livia of Ukraine.
Alia Atkinson is getting off to a nice start. You're travelling underwater with her there. She finished 6th at the World Shore Course in the 50 metres breaststroke, and this is her third Olympic Games. So nicely done by her in the first 50 metres, but being challenged by Van Biljon as well.
So Atkinson turns 23/100 in front of Van Biljon, and then Shokova, and that split was 31.42.
Yeah, we're starting to see much faster splits now. That was a great turn by Atkinson. She is really increasing her stroke rate. 31.42 at the 50 metre mark, so now we're talking with much faster times. 108s here in the offering.
So good lead, hasn't she? You see lane 4, because then he's a fair way back, the fastest on entry time. So if Jamaica leading South Africa at the moment, you don't say Jamaica leading in swimming races too often. You do it at a bigger stadium than this. Let's see if she can hang on. I think she will. Atkinson. And that time, that's really quick. That's 67.39. That is fast.
That's a great swim. Personal best time for her. What a wonderful performance. She'll be happy with that. That should get her through to the semi-final.
Is that her third Olympics, did you say?
Third Olympic Games.
She's only 23 years of age, so she's obviously 15 in Athens.
There's another Atkinson that has made freestyle finals for Jamaica in the swimming pool, so we need to find out if it's a sister, perhaps. But she is a wonderful breaststroker, and that really boosts her up in the world rankings as well.
Yeah, that was a great swim.
107.38, that moves her right up.
So there's the official heat result, Alia Atkinson in 67.39. Suzanne Van Biljon in 67.54. That's a very good swim for her as well. And Sarah El Bekri, 68.21. So all those women with personal best. Heat 4. Zhao Xin in lane 1 of China. And then Matsushima Tyler. Liesl Jones here, the big story, a fourth Olympics, first Australian swimmer. Here she is, first Australian swimmer to go to four Olympic Games. What a record she has.
It's an amazing record of Olympic success, world championship success, and also Commonwealth Games. Leeston Pickett, her teammate, though, beat Liesl Jones at the Australian Championships. So she, at the moment, is the number one breaststroker for Australia. And she's sitting at the moment ranked number 5 in the world, Leeston Pickett.
So Jones has one of every colour from Sydney through to Beijing, a gold, a silver and a bronze.
Take your mark.
Heat 4, 100 breaststroke. And the defending Olympic champion here is in lane number 4, Liesl Jones, a 27-year-old at her fourth Olympics. And let's see how she goes. Great start by a Melutite there of Lithuania in the green cap. She was clearly in front. Been a lot of talk about Jones and just how ready she is for this championship back home. But one thing about her, she's a great technician.
Yes, but she also swims a better second half of the 100 metres as well. So she will start to move her way through. Melutite's come out very, very fast in the first 50.
She's put down a mark of 30.58, so it's about a second lead she has over the two Australians in Jones and Pickett.
Jones starting to move her way through now, the Olympic champion with the yellow cap there. So she'll start to take some water off Melutite. She'll start to fatigue on picking, but we'll wait to see in the last 25 metres now.
So Melutite still with a good lead here.
Yeah.
She's only 15 years of age, of Lithuania, so this has been a great performance by her. In fact, they're not going to get it. She's holding Jones and Pickett for sure, and lane one, Zhao, not far away. Now, this looks quick. It looks really quick. It's 65.56. She was born in March 1997.
105.56. That is a huge personal best time.
She knows it all. Have a look at the response. Well,
what an amazing point in time. Breaststrokers tend to develop quite young. Liesl went to her first Olympic Games at just 14. It is the world number one ranked time of 2012. Rebecca Soni previously held it coming in at 105.82.
Just looking at the all-time list as well. So 65.56 gets her into eighth place on the all-time list.
Fantastic effort.
So a stunning result here, a 15-year-old, 65.56. Liesl Jones, 66.98, that's a pretty good swim. And Liesl Pickett in 67.41.
It is the same with the 400 IM for women. You can't stop anyone from having the swim of their life. And this young girl is overwhelmed with the fact that she's just done the fastest time in the world.
I saw a Lithuanian yesterday, and I was always going to question the fact that we don't see a lot of Lithuanian top-class swimmers. Correct me if I'm wrong, but...
No.
It's not a country you hear a lot about in swimming, do you?
In the early 1990s, just after the separation of the USSR, then there were a lot of great swimmers from that area.
From the Baltic states,
yes. Well, not for a long time.
We've got one now, really.
Wow.
So here's the next of the heats. And well, suddenly there's a new challenger, isn't there, from nowhere. But here's Bridget Larson, who you talked about earlier. What a breakthrough this year.
Yeah, she wanted to be a gymnast when she was a kid, but her dad said to her she was going to be too tall. She said he was a dream crusher until she found something that she was suited to, and isn't she suited to it?
Kate Haywood here for Great Britain in lane 8, so there's the lineup.
Take your mark.
So heat 5 in the 100 breaststroke for women. Hostman, Sweden 1. Van Buren, Canada 2. Pedersen of Denmark 3. Larson, USA 4. Suzuki, Japan 5. Lunau, Germany in 6. Liu Zhijiao of China in 7. And Haywood of Great Britain in 8.
Larson didn't get off to a fantastic start. She had the slowest of the reaction times. But once she hit the water, she certainly made up for it. Comes up very high with her breaststroke, but the mouth and the head stay very low. Beautiful technique. Lane number 2, Van Buren is also going well.
And lane 6, Runau. So let's see the turn here. It's Larson just in front of Runau and Pedersen. So the time was 31.31, the split. We've just seen a sensational previous heat. This is more of a contest. There's 5 all in a row just about.
Yeah, you've got to race the race in this situation. Peripheral vision does work, so they'll be aware of where the other girls are. This is a test for Bridget Larson, her first Olympic race.
But she looks like she's pulling away. Suzuki and Pedersen, both with black caps, are trying to reel her in. Larson had a fast one of 65.92. She beat Sony at the American Trials, and she's holding on here. It's going to be high 66s, I think. In fact, middle 66s, 66.58. Larson over Suzuki and Pedersen. Good swim.
Big smile on her face. What an amazing period of time she's had. Last year had her best time of 1:10, now down to a 1:05. She wins the heat of her first Olympic appearance. Fantastic vision you're seeing here. Into the wall and very short stroking into the wall. Doesn't decide to go for the long glide off that stroke, takes another stroke. It's always an on-the-spot decision that the breaststrokers make. They do try to adjust it, seeing the wall coming up.
Bit of relief as well. I mean, nerves jiggling at your first Olympic swim. And that result, Bridget Larson is 66.58. So Tommy Suzuki, 67.08. And Rika Pedersen, 67.23.
She goes to A&M Uni in Texas, the Aggies. Another one from the Aggies here at the competition.
And second fastest so far. So Rebecca Soni here, the Olympic silver medalist from this event, but really the dominant breaststroker since Beijing,
yes,
hasn't she? I mean, she broke through in Beijing with the 200. There she is. Very strong at the end of the 100, isn't she?
Absolutely. Given the 200-meter base that she has, being Olympic champion, she does come home very quickly. Effa Mobile will be out fast.
Take your mark.
So those middle lanes to watch, but from the top from Spain, Babila, Powell, Germany in two, Johansson, Sweden three, Sony four, Efimova, Russia five, Diva, Russia six, Nahus of Holland in seven, O'Connor of Great Britain in lane eight.
And it looks as though Diva, who had the fastest reaction time, is taking it out. So too, Sarah Poe up there in lane number two.
It's her fourth Olympic, Sarah Poe. So it looks like she might just have the lead. The veteran, the 29-year-old German, she does. It's very quick. It's 31.09. Efimova second, Diva third. So, Sony, we know the back half will be tough.
Yeah, here she comes now. She's really putting her foot down. That's 15 metres off the wall, coming up to the 25-metre mark. And Rebecca Sony is really putting her foot down now. Can Sarah over in lane number two hold on? No. Here comes Rebecca Sony.
And Efimova trying to go with her in the pink cap. Great shot underwater again. Now, 65.56 is the fastest time in the world this year. We saw it in one of her earlier heats. This is going to be pretty close to that, I reckon. Oh, it's 65.75. It's just a little slower, but not by much. Terrific swim by Rebecca Soni. So, 65.75. She's so strong
with
in the back 50, isn't
yeah,
she?
Yeah, she really moves her way through beautifully. Stays very low in the water. Efimova in the pink cap comes up very high. And here she is. The mouth is only just clearing the water level. You see the hands in the up palm position and then they roll over to palm down. You can see how she goes on the wall, the full stroke on the wall.
There's the eye of the tiger when she swims over, don't you?
Yeah, she does. And that eye of the tiger helped her get in really on a full stroke.
Here's the result of heat six. Rebecca Soni in 65.75. Efimova 66.51. Sarah Poe in 67.12. So the six heats completed. The semi-final lineup will be as follows. And there's a big surprise here. A new name in breaststroking. That's a familiar name and a familiar sight. A great champion, hoping to add the 100 breaststroke to the Olympic 200. She's been the world champion in this event in the last two world championships, 2009 and 2011. And so the summary, and that's the new name. Now you're tied at 65.56. Absolutely stunning.
Can you imagine the world media right now scrambling to find out information about this Lithuanian swimmer?
Absolutely. I mean, she's suddenly burst like a shining star. Sony Efimova last. So Jones has done a good job.
Into fifth.
As we go down, Pedersen, who's had a rib problem this year.
Atkinson from Jamaica makes it through.
Pickett got through as well. And then the two Canadians, so down to 67.85.